I do not know how to use this mic, and it is frustrating. So, hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Alice Nxumalo. If you are new here and joining me for the first time, please click the subscribe button down below to become a member of my family. And if you are irregular, thank you for coming back. Thank you for choosing my channel yet again. So today it is one of those Vlogtober videos. I don't know which Vlogtober number we are at actually. I do not know, but we are still on Vlogtober, so I am getting ready for shift, and I decided to tell you a story of a year where I spend my December holidays indoors because Gisasho namanje, man will leave you in the desert without water. So, remember the story time about my ex-boyfriend who made us sleep in the same bed, the three of us. After that incident, he became my stalker. I would be sitting at home and I'll see him at the corners of the street, or he will pass by my home 3 or 4 times a day. Like those unnecessary passes, you see, when somebody passes and then after a while they pass again. Like that was unnecessary if you ask me, because it felt like even at night. You know, at the villages, we are situated next to each other. So if they wanted to send me to at my mom's sister's house, I would be scared to go at night because I don't know whether I will meet him up on the streets or what. Because we broke up, I did not know what he wanted from me, and I did not want anything to do with him. So he just basically became my stalker and terrorized me for a few months or a year, and then he stopped after seeing that I am not in to his requests. So, but that was not the end of my problems. That was just the beginning of my problems, because now I broke up with him. He did not go back to his ex-girlfriend, the one that he had before me. He did not go back to her. Guys, I'm going to work. Hope I'm not gonna be late. Hello. I'll be back. Sorry, I got distracted. I don't know whether I'm still in frame or what. Don't mind the white residue. It is my Native child, leave-in moisturizer, leave-in condition. But when I use it as a hair oil, a hair food or something, yeah, I use it as a. So, okay, gave up. But that was not the end of my problems. Remember the ex-girlfriend that he broke up with while he was dating me? Not the one that we slept in the same bed. The one that we. I knew her from distance. We were not friends. We were not anything. I knew her from a distance. So apparently, when I what I heard is that he broke up with her because of me. So Ugel was angry at me because Mina, I took him and Mina, I did not know. And both these people were older than me. Because Ugai was 8 years, yeah, he was 8 years older than me, and Ugel was 5 years older than me. So Yena and Ugai were the same age, but Mina, because in Kandizinto, I was like with a guy who's 8 years older than me, because I was 21, I think I was 21, and he was 29, at that time. So And then Mina, my body, my big body always worked in my favor because you can tell, Uti, I am not that old. You can't really tell. You, some people can tell, saying, no, we can see by your face, but some can't tell. So my body always worked in my favor because you couldn't tell, Uti, I was young. And when I dated someone my age, it looked like I was the older one, even though I was not. So, yeah. That's why I think I attracted attention of older guys, not old, but older than me guys, if you know what I mean. I'm not planning to wear a wig today. I'm gonna wear my natural hair, so I need to comb it thoroughly. So guys, it was festive. Yeah, but my festive seasons are busy. And there's this best friend of mine. We are, you know, Emakaya, we are related. Our grandmothers and our what, our cousins and what, we are related. But she is my best friend. She is still my best friend even today. And she was reminding me of this story, I think 3 months ago. So yeah, we are still friends even now. So she's, one day we were sitting at her place. It was festive season. So we were sitting at her home because it was not far. You know, those are houses in the villages. We are not far from each other. We are in different houses, but it is not very far. You can just walk from here to there and there to here. So it was not far. So I usually spend most of my time at her home. So I spend a lot of time with her. She was my best friend. She still is my best friend even today. So yeah. So one day we were sitting at her house, and her oldest sister says to me that we're gonna name the other lady the ex-girlfriend Opel. She says to me, Opel, the ex-girlfriend, the subscriber, says she wants to ruin your face. Mina, my face, and she says yes. She's planning to ruin your face this festive season. This festive season. And I'm like, okay. But then how is she going to ruin my face? I can't remember, I don't know. I can't remember, I'm a little backward and Ugeli is a little upward. So we're gonna name her Opel. She says, no, Opel is planning Uti. If you guys go to a, you know, when we were growing up, there were these taverns where you could just go. They will call out those people that will dance to those people that dance traditional dances and stuff, and they will come and entertain us during festive season. So what we will normally do is we'll normally go there. And my best friend was 7 or 8 years older than me as well. So she had a boyfriend, a steady boyfriend that we all knew. So he said, we normally went to the taverns with the guy because he was older as well. So when we go anywhere with him, we know we are safe. So he says, no, Opel is planning to ruin your face. She says he wants to make a scar on your face, a scar that will be a reminder to you that you took her boyfriend. And I'm like, what kind of a scar is that? She says, no, she's gonna pour flammable liquids on your face, and then it's gonna ruin your face. Guys, did I not spend Christmas indoors and all the other holidays that come after Christmas, that come with Christmas and after Christmas? Did I not spend them indoors because you know I was scared somebody's gonna ruin my face? I'm jolly. So she says, and I'm like, I'm not scared of her. I'm not scared of her. I'll fight for myself. And she's like, when an Opel is ghetto like that, so you shouldn't fight with her. And my friend was like, no, she won't do anything. As long as we are around, she won't do anything. We are not scared of her. She must just go and talk to her boyfriend and leave Alice alone. We are not scared of her. And we were like, yeah, we are not scared of her. But deep down, I was terrified. Deep down, I was terrified. Like, I did not know what she planned to do with my face, number one. And I did not know the consequences that's gonna come with her ruining my face, number two. And then Upelvele was ghetto. She was ghetto, and a lot of people were scared of her, and a lot of people liked her because when you are ghetto like that, people like you so that they don't get on your wrong side. Yeah, they don't get on your wrong side. So Upel was threatening to pour acid on my face or any flammable liquids. I don't know what she planned to use, but Mina, yes, remember what I told you about my natural hair? Now it's breaking. My natural hair can grow so fast without me noticing or without me allowing. But look at it now, how grown it is. So Opel was planning everything, and then my friend's sister, who's also my cousin, she told me, but and I'm like, no, I'm not scared of Opel. And she says, because she was an instigator, she says, if you're not scared of her, let's go and we'll see what she's gonna do to you. And then our male cousin, not the cousin that was friends with or subscriber, and another cousin, because at home we are all related. Yeah, let me tell you one thing, we are all related. So our male cousin was like, no, when I see you are instigating that, you go there, and then what if she does something drastic to her face and you'll end up regretting? Because when you're saying if she's not scared, man, one thing about me, I'll fight my battles, but I was scared of Pelsham. I don't want to lie. Upeliana, no, I was scared of her. One thing about me, I do fight my battles, but Upel, I was very, very scared of her. So, the brother was like, no, you're not going. Because we all know Upel can get ghetto like that, and then we cannot get you 24/7. Like, cannot go with you and get you 24/7. We will want to do other things. And then what if she attacks while we are not watching, and then she does something drastic to you, and then we all have to answer for that at the end of the day, because we were there with you. The best way is for you not to go. So, guys, I'm going on night shift. I'm just fixing myself, but and I was like, no, I wanna go, and then I'll fight my own battles. But deep down, I was scared of Upel. Upel was. Whenever I would meet Upel on the streets, she will not say anything to me. Now I have hiccups. I remember Akira guys, we used to stay not far from each other. Like, we stayed at the same village. Even though it's not closer, but it was not that far. So whenever I would go to town, I will meet Upel and Jeline, and she will not say anything to me. Or if she's with her friends, she'll normally do those indirect speeches. Most when we were growing up, kemba, she would do that. But because Mina, I always told myself, it's okay. Point number one, I am scared of Upel. Point number two, if Pearl doesn't come to me straight and say something or attack me, I will not fight her. I'm scared of her. I will not fight her. So if she does those indirect speaking, not speaking to me directly, I will not respond. And she will do that a lot. And I will be like, every time. But because I was scared of Upel, and then there was nothing I can do about it. And really, truth be told, bengimcalile Upel because I dated i boyfriend yakhe. But i-boyfriend yakhe who told me that they broke up because Upel was unfaithful and stuff. Can't you know, Ukai was also doing the same thing to Upel. So I think Upel was doing everything to back to sender. But then Upel, when she did ama back to sender, Ukai left her for real and came to me. So it was me, it was Pearl, and it was the other lady. So yeah, the other lady, I never met her again ever in my life. I don't even know, even if I meet her today, I won't even tell if it is her, because I've never seen her anyway. After that incident, I've never seen her anyway. Today, even if I meet her today, I won't tell. Would you? This is the one. So upele 16 December, I am at home, and I am not going anywhere far from home, because when I'm in the ranges of my home, I know that my sisters are there. Everybody at home is there. But if I meet Upel somewhere where there is no one, uzongilwela, it's going to be a very, very, very complicated situation. So I was staying at home, and then 16 December came, and then it was one of those traditional dances. And then Upeli was, she was drinking a lot. Like, when we were growing up, we used to tell ourselves, Upeli doesn't have a future, because she was fearless. Upeli, she would do anything. So I was scared of her, because we know that she will go below the belt for anything. So I was scared of her. And deep down, my friends, my best friend also was scared of her. But because that was not her battle to fight, it was mine and mine alone. So yeah, I was scared of Upen. So when the 16th December came, and then we were supposed to go and see, I don't know what you call this, but it's traditional dance. It's only traditional dance. In our language, we call it umchongolo. So umchongolo came, and then people were going there, and I was like sitting at home, scared to do anything because of Upen. So my friend said, no, let's go. But as soon as we see Upen, we leave. And then we went. Then we went there, and we did not see Upel that day. And then my cousin, the older cousin, my friend's sister, she says to me, yeah, Upel heard that you guys were there at the traditional dance on the 16th. So now she is planning that she is going there on the 25th. On Christmas Day, she's going there, and if you are there, all hell's gonna break loose. Hey guys, did I not spend Christmas watching TV? They were all gone, and worst part, they were all gone. I was left alone. I was left at home with my grandmother, but I don't call her my grandmother. I normally call her Ma. I don't call her my grandmother. I don't think she's my grandmother. She's Ma. Ma meaning my mother, my mother's sister. This story is complicated, guy. My mother's sister, my friend's mother. I call her Ma, but I call her Mas Mang Mang, so I won't say that now. But when I call her Veli, I call her Mas Mang Mang. So yeah, so I ended up spending Christmas with her, watching TV, when all the girls went, and she wanted to know why, but we couldn't tell her what was going on. So I spent the rest of my Christmas and New Year's and everything indoors, because I was scared of Upen. And then I was scared of Upen of early, because I took her boyfriend, a boyfriend that I was no longer with, a boyfriend that was abusing me. Guys, I've been through the most. I deserve to go to I must send twins and tell them that I've been through the most, Nina. Because, number one, the boyfriend that Upel wanted to beat me up for was no longer my boyfriend. Number two, the boyfriend was busy terrorizing me, and Upel was busy terrorizing me. I remember telling him that Upel is terrorizing me. Please tell Upel, Nina, now we broke up, so she will leave me alone. He said, no, I will not tell Pell anything. Wena, if you want, you can come back to me, and I will protect her. I will protect you from Pell, the abuser protecting me from my whatever she wanted to be, Pell. So my abuser and my stalker wanted to protect me from his crazy girlfriend, Pell. Guys, so one day, one of my friend's sisters, because she had two older sisters and two older brothers. So one of the older sisters of my friend, who's my cousin, sat down with Pell, because they knew Pell. So she sat down with Pell and told her, you shouldn't do that to them again. I can't know, I was young and Pell was old. So they told her that you shouldn't do that to her. If you want to fight your battles, go fight with your boyfriend. Because if you do anything to her, her whole family is gonna get involved and it's gonna get messy. So you are not, and I did not even tell my sister at home what was going on, because my sister, I got na, I went back to the abuser to subscribe without telling my sister. And then when all hell broke loose, when I told my sister, she was like, "No, Mina, what I know is that you and that guy broke up. Whatever you are saying now doesn't concern me. Because Mina, what I know, you told me that you broke up with him, you're no longer with him. So whatever you're doing now, it's no longer my concern. Because Mina, I won't go back and forth with your situation. It's either you're out or you are in." So when he started doing that, when he started beating me up, I could not even tell my own sister because of that. So I broke up with him. He terrorized me. I could not even tell my sister. But I think at the end I told her, and then she told my brothers. That's why he stopped. Because you know, he said, "No, when he was just passing, Mina, I'm just scared. Mina, I'm just, Mina, I just want to control what he does. Mina, I just want to control where he goes." But guys, I'm telling you, he did not go. He did not pass by my house just for just. He was passing there just to terrorize me. But you know, he ended up saying the stories, and then they told him to stop, and he stopped. But then when Upel was terrorizing me, I went back to him. I called him and I told him, and he said, "Nah, I'll see you when I come back from work." He was working in Witbank, I think, or Secunda. So he said, "I will see you when I come back from work. Then we'll talk about it." Hey, guy. I wanted to talk about us getting back together. You know, I wanted to talk about him telling Upel to leave me the hell alone. But Yena, he had his other motives. And thank goodness I did not give in to whatever he wanted, because he ended up going to Upel. And then Upel ended up telling people that Mina, I couldn't keep the man. So the man came back to Mina. I was like, "Guy, sissy, you keep your abuser. Mina, I'm not gonna get into a competition for an abuser. You keep your abuser, Mina, and you leave me the hell alone." He ended up with Upel, but Mina, my December was ruined by our plans, Agapel, because Pel wanted to pour my face with acid. Guys, I only see acid survivors on TV. I did not want to experience that on myself. I did not want to experience that on myself, and I did not know the process of everything. Like, I was so terrified. I spent the whole of December indoors scared of Upel because she wanted to pour my face with flammable liquids. Can you imagine? Can you? Is she okay upstairs? Because what I heard or what I know from that is that they broke up long time ago. She's not even married to him. So imagine if she ruined my face and then she's not even married to him. They are no longer together, but my face is ruined because of him. How I know now, guys. Ladies, guys, Lena, this groove say loose somewhere. It cannot be. You've got like a loose screw somewhere in your head. You cannot do that. She ruined my entire Christmas. She ruined my entire festive season because now I was scared, guys. Can you just imagine? That motho o re batla o tshela ka acid, or motho o re batla o batla o want to make me a scar with a beer bottle. I see those guys, body scars from a beer bottle, they don't look nice. So imagine. So yeah, guys, that's how the story went, where Upel threatened to burn my face with acid, or she threatened to make me a scar with a beer bottle so that nobody's gonna notice me. And then one other thing is that if nobody's gonna notice me, it means that your boyfriend will be stuck with me. And when you want your boyfriend back, why can't you just do something that you're gonna get your boyfriend back and leave me the hell alone? So yeah, guys, I spent my festive season indoors, not far from home, because I was scared of Upe, who wanted to burn my face with acid and ruin my face with a beer bottle. Things that women do for men. I wonder if men will do the same for us. I wonder. But anyway, guys, that's the end of the story of my stalker boyfriend and her crazy ex-girlfriend who wanted to burn me with acid. I still look at acid survivors and I still like. It could have been me. It could have been me. If I did not take extra precautions, it could have been me. But I'm glad Mina gave, because Mina, whenever I see that this is a losing battle, I do not fight him. I do fight my battles, but when I see that this one is a losing battle, I do not fight it. I cut all ties. I cut all ties and move on with my life. So that's what I did. I avoided Pen, and then I avoided her boyfriend, and then that's the end of the story time. If you did enjoy the story time, please click the subscribe button down below to become a member of my family. And then please don't forget to like the video while watching. I will see you in my next upload, guys. I need to get dressed. I'm going to work. Bye.